तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः सच्चिदानन्द रूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादि हेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्री कृष्णाय वयम् नमः श्री कृष्णाय वयम् नमः ॐ यो न प्रविश्य मम वाचमिमां प्रसुप्तां सञ्जीवयत्यखिल शक्तिधरस्वधाम्नाम् अन्याश्च हस्तचरण श्रवणत्वदायी प्राणानमो भवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् प्राणान्नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम् प्राणान्नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यम्
वी आर इन भागवतम कैंटो 10 वर्स नंबर व्हाट वर्स नंबर एनीवन रिमेंबर्स वेयर वी डिड टिल लास्ट टाइम
यस स्वामी
29, 28. Shri Bhagavan Vacha. So we saw last time that Uddhavji Maharaj, having seen the overwhelming love of the gopis for their beloved Lord, he couldn't stop but praise the gopis, and here. Listening to these expressions of the gopis of their love towards their beloved, he wanted to bring their hearts and mind to peace. And for that, there's only one Ramban. And what is that Ramban? The message, the secret message that Krishna has sent to the gopis through Uddhavji Maharaj. And that message was given to him, and there it was told that he praises them first, because he is not giving the message before he is creating a bhumika. Bhumika is he is creating a foundation, not for the gopis, for himself. Because he is himself overwhelmed by the expression of the love of the gopis. He is feeling their pain. He is feeling their joy. He is feeling their ecstasy. He is feeling their thirst to be with the Lord. And recognizing that, he told our gopis, O gopis, that you have already accomplished what all the Mahatmas, all the yogis, all the scriptures, all the tapasvis, all the ascetics, what they are seeking out to achieve, you have already achieved without doing anything. Dhanyo, you are really, indeed you are great. And in this way, he is expressing his appreciation of the state that they are in. And continuing, he says that you have given me a great boon. Uddhav Maharaj is saying. And what is that boon? That I have never come across or experienced such love being expressed towards another person. Krishna is a person for them, even though he is God for them, but he is a person just like we talk about Mahatmas. He says, I have witnessed this love with my own eyes and with my own mind, and I am really, really grateful for the experience that you have made me go through. And therefore, out of joy and out of pain for you. I am happy to give you the message, and because you are, I see that you are in so much pain for due to his separation, that I give you this message, the secret message that the Lord has asked me to deliver to you. And with that, here, instead of saying Uddhava Uvacha, it says Shri Bhagavana Uvacha. So he is repeating exactly the words of the Lord, what the Lord told him to convey to the gopis. We'll read this paragraph till 33. भवती ना श्री भगवान उवाच भवती नाम वियोगो मे नहि सर्वात्मना क्वचित यथा भूतानि भूतेषु खं वायवग्निर्जलं मही तथा हम च मन प्राण भूतेन्द्रिय गुणाश्रयः तथा हम च मन प्राण भूतेन्द्रिय गुणाश्रयः आत्मन्येवात्मनात्मानं सृजेऽहन्यनुपालये आत्मभावेन भूतेन्द्रियगुणात्मना आत्मा ज्ञानमयः शुद्धो व्यतिरिक्तो गुणान्वयः सुषुप्तिस्वप्रजाग्नग्भिः मायावृत्तिभिरीयते येनेन्द्रियार्थान् ध्यायेत मृषा स्वप्नवदुत्थितः तन्निरुद्ध्यादीन्द्रियाणि विनिद्रः प्रत्यपद्यत एतदन्तसमान्नायो योगसाङ्ख्यं मनीषिणां त्यागस्तपोदमः सत्यं समुद्रान्ता इव अपगाः. So here in the, we are in the 29th verse. So the Lord is telling that Uddhavji is saying, what the Lord has said? Lord has said that I am the material cause and the efficient cause of the creation. What is material cause? That material out of which something is created. What is efficient cause? The one who creates that creation. So Lord says, I am the creator and I am the material also out of which this whole creation has been created. You will say, yes, we understand. You don't understand anything. You cannot understand. How can the same thing be a material as well as the creator? You cannot understand. But very intelligently we say, yes, we understand. And very intelligently we also say, this is how the Lord said. Nobody can understand that. We can only appreciate it. That's it. When it clicks, then it will reveal. So, he says, I am the Upadan Karan and the Nimitta Karan. And I am permeating everything in this creation as the Atma of every being. In 8th chapter, Bhagavan says, I am the Brahman, essentially, and I am expressing as Atma in all the beings. The body also is made out of me only. And having created the body, out of me meaning, because of him, the Prakriti came, Prakriti multiplied, and the space, air, fire, water, earth, five elements came. These five elements mix with each other and the various forms are created. And then after creating the form, he enters. So he enters what? He enters himself. He doesn't enter you. He enters himself. And when he enters into a body, he is expressing as the Atma, the witness. But when he gets identified with the body, then he is called the individual, only with identification. Without identification, he is the witness. Is identification possible? No, but we are not going into that topic right now. Here, We'll just listen to what Lord is saying. He says that there is nothing in this creation, neither the space nor the air, fire, water, earth. These are the five great elements that have been, that have come out of the Maya, the Prakriti, the potentiality of mine. And that also, that potentiality, that unmanifest potentiality also I am pervading. It cannot be without me, and when it expresses as sattva, rajas, tamas, and eventually as the space, air, fire, water, earth, and eventually as the five senses, sense organs of perception, and five organs of action, and mana, buddhi, chitta, ankar, mind, intellect, memory, and ego, everything is pervaded by me and me alone. There is nothing else other than me in this creation. But that is not our experience. To have that experience, we have to be like gopis. Only then that experience will come. Otherwise it will not. See, the story is, how come Lord is telling straight away such a highest truth to the gopis? And for Arjuna he told 18 chapters. 18 chapters. And this thought which he is telling here, he tells Arjuna in the 13th chapter, I think, Kshetra Vibhaga Yoga. So for so many chapters, what he is doing with Arjuna? What preparing him? Good, that's a good word. He is cleaning the slate. He is cleaning the slate. He is cleaning the mirror of his mind with words, with various practices, with the understanding, with knowledge. And then he presents this knowledge. So do you want to be like Arjuna? Who is Arjuna? Confused, yes. He is like where is our Chutki? Bhageshri, she is starting school tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Arjuna is like that. Arjuna is like that fellow, like that girl. Starting the school, so he has to be given 18 chapters. 18 years of school. In condensed. But who are gopis? They are already prepared. They are already prepared. For them, straight away the knowledge is given. And we will see if they appreciate it or not. And therefore he says, all these, this whole universe, this whole cosmos is in me. I am in the whole cosmos. And if you really ask, I alone am expressing as the various names and forms that you see in this creation. Whether you recognize me in these names and forms, or recognize me as these names and forms, that's a different matter. But from Lord's point of view, there can nothing be other than Him. It's like ocean saying that I am pervading all the names and forms. What is the names and forms appearing on the water? All the waves. So ocean is, the water is saying, I am pervading all the forms. It's true. So where is the waveness? Only in our mind. See? Like that. And here in this verse it says, Bhavati naam vyogo me nahi sarvatmana kvachita yatha bhutani bhuteshu kham vayavagnir jalam mahi tathaham cha manaprana bhutendriya gunashrayaha. So with these he says that I am the substratum of the mind. I am also the substratum of the prana, the life force that is expressing through you, and bhutendriya gunashrayaha, and also all the indriyas, all the sense perceptions and the sense organs, everything, all the expressions in this creation are pervaded by me and me alone. This first instruction to the gopis. What was the first instruction to Arjuna? You remember? In the second chapter. First he scolded him. Klebya masma gama parra. Don't be a nimcumcoop. He was scolded. Here, no scolding. Straight away, the ultimate. See, when it comes to, one example was Arjuna. Second example is this gopis. Third example you take is of the, take Tulsidas ji. What happened to Tulsidas ji? Did he ask for, he asked, Hanuman ji, please give, make me have darshan of what? Shri Ram and Lakshman ji, please. He has studied the scriptures, he has studied the Gita, he has studied the Upanishads for so many years. For so many years he has studied the scriptures. And when you study so much scriptures for so many years without experiencing what the scriptures are indicating, not telling, indicating. They can only indicate because the truth is beyond the scriptures. Truth is beyond the word. See? But here, gopis have got no issue like this. They don't care whether Lord gives a message or he doesn't give. Why? We will see later. They did not, like our, Tulsidas ji. Tulsidas ji was a saint in India, in Varanasi. Tulsidas ji had all the knowledge. Uddhav ji, the one who is giving this message to gopis, he has all the knowledge. But he doesn't have the experience of the knowledge. People write PhDs after PhDs. When I was in Varanasi, in one ashram, and my next door neighbor, room, he was doing PhD on yoga. PhD on yoga. And what topic he has chosen in yoga? Pranayam. And certain results of pranayam and what happens with that practices and etc. etc. So one day I have been so many first few weeks and then I became friends and I started talking. And he said, Swamiji, please tell me something this about that, about this. I said, you are doing a PhD. How do you do research? I have never seen you doing pranayam. How you are coming to conclusions? He says, library Zindabad. So he's just collecting information from here, there and writing. This information was collected from this book. This collection, this book. And he's coming to a new conclusion. That's all. Is that what PhD is? There are so many philosophers talking about philosophy in or having done PhD in philosophy. But do they know what the truth is? This is the state of Uddhav. This is the state of Tulsidas ji while he was in that situation. He became a devotee after. See? So, but what about gopis? They are not having an appreciation of this Krishna bhav. They are not having an appreciation, oh, when I merge into the divine. No, they are, while living, every moment of their existence abiding in, saturated fully by the Krishna bhav. See? Saturated fully, homogeneously. There is not even one iota of any corruption in their being, in their understanding, in their appreciation, if you want to use it. Their mind is not coming in between. They have merged into him. And yet the game of life continues. Yet they complain, yet they fight, yet they are angry with Krishna. But what is the goal of that anger? Krishna. What is the goal of the pain? Pain, for whom is the pain expressed? For Krishna. Then for whom is the joy expressed? Also for Krishna. For them, whole life is Krishna, 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 Krishna. No other theme is appreciated in their mind. Because they know Krishna is not other than them. They have experienced him directly. Direct experience does not mean I am experiencing you directly. I am experiencing the words in Bhagavatam directly. This is not direct experience. This is paroksha anubhuti. This is indirect experience. I am separate from the words in the book. I am separate from all of you people. Direct experience is, indirect experience is, I know there is a chocolate and I am appreciating the chocolate. Direct experience is when that chocolate and me become one. That is direct experience. There's no difference between the experiencer and the experienced object. So if experiencer is the gopis, the village girls, and the experienced is the divine Lord, there is no difference in their experience of the Lord. They know he is us and we are him. That's it. No question about it. And they are completely entrenched deeply into the in the Lord as the Lord, in the truth. And in this way, here in the next verse he says, Atmanyevatmanatmanam suruje hanyam. What is that word? Hanmya. Hanmya numalaye atma maya nubhavena bhutendriya gunatmana. In the 30th verse, the Lord says, Lord is telling the gopis that I myself, with my own potentiality, through my potentiality, all the material, all the sense organs, and all the stimuli for the sense organs, I alone have become. Nothing from outside of me has come to become the sense stimuli. What are the sense stimuli? If eyes are the seer, whatever is seen is the sense stimuli for the organ called eye, sense perception called eye. For the ears, the words are the sense perception, all the sounds are the, not just words, all the sounds are the sense stimuli. For the tongue, it's the taste. For the nose, it's the smell. For the skin, it's the feeling. In this way, all these five, seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting, all these sense stimuli is nothing but the Lord. All the senses which are experiencing these sense stimuli is nothing but the Lord. The one who is experiencing from within is nothing but the Lord. So, I only create everything, I only maintain everything, and I only destroy everything. Nothing is outside of me. Atma jnanamaya shuddho vyatirikto gunanvayaha sushupti swapna jagratbihi maya vrutti bhiriyate. Atma jnanamaya shuddho vyatirikto gunanvayaha. So in the 31st verse he says that Atma, the self, the reality, even though the potentiality cannot is my own expression, but when the self is other than the expression of Maya, the intelligent principle, the reality, the principle of reality, the divinity, it is other than all the functioning of the Maya. Meaning what? That it is other than the functioning of the Maya. It supports the functioning of the Maya, it supports the functioning of the ignorance, it supports the functioning of the nature, but itself does not get affected by the nature. What happens to us? What is the difference between us and the Lord? We get affected by our own nature. We get affected by our own speech. We get affected by our own seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting. Even scratching. We scratch, 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 so after some time, blood. Then go to doctor. Who is Lord? He has, out of his own potentiality, his potentiality is called Maya. What is your potentiality called? Think. If his potentiality is called Maya, at a microcosmic level that we are, what is our potentiality? No. What is your potentiality?
Jiva.
No.
Jiva.
No. Your potentiality is your mind. Then that mind expands into everything. Without mind, you cannot perceive this world. But we are enslaved by the mind. We are servants of our mind. It dictates what we should do, how should we behave, how should we feel, how should we... Lord, He is the master of His potentiality. We are slaves of our potentiality. Gopis are not slaves of their potentiality. Their mind has become Krishnamaya. It has become divinized. See? What will you say? This computer is going on. One virus comes in. What will happen? What do we say it has become? So the whole computer has become, so operating system has got corrupted. Our operating system is what? Our mind. Is the operating system the computer? No. Operating system is other than the computer. Where does the operating system exist? Tell me. In its own absence. All hard disk, where does the material go? 1 terabyte. There is nothing inside the terabyte. You go and open it, you will not find anything. Only empty, nothing. In that nothingness, all the data, 1 terabyte of data is stored. You go to look for the mind, there will be no mind. Yet, it is there at the moment. This is the conundrum that we have to solve in life. This is the spiritual journey. So these gopis, they are functioning through their mind, but their mind is completely divinized. What has happened to their mind? A virus has entered. And what is that virus called? Krishna. And it has divinely corrupted the entire operating system. Now what is happening because of that operating system? Whatever the mind only functions through the eyes, all the 5 senses and organs of action. So whatever it sees, hears, touches, feels, tastes, does, not, doesn't do, everything is Krishna, 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 Krishna. Or whatever name you want to take of the Lord. Any name. The principle is the same. Whether you take it to be Jesus, whether you take it to be Shiva, whether you take it to be Ganesha, is the same process. This is what happens to a devotee. So here, the Lord is saying, that Sushupti Swapna Jagrat Bihi Maya Vritti Bhiriyate. In the 31st verse, the Lord is saying that this Atma, this Self, this conscious self, different names for the same thing. This conscious self or this reality within, it is other than the functioning of the Maya, and it is absolutely pure. Nothing can corrupt it ever. Can a wave corrupt water? Can a ornament corrupt the gold? Can a pot corrupt the mud? Whether mud is there on the earth, or that mud is in a pot. It is still, it remains as mud only. Similarly, all this mind, this intellect, this breath, this body, these senses, these sense organs of action, and if you keep extending further, the whole stimuli that is this whole world, it cannot corrupt the self. Recognize this about you right now. He is telling the gopis that this Atma that you essentially are, it is other than the Prakriti. It is other than the potentiality. Recognize. And how do you recognize it? He says that this Maya, what is this Maya now? By which the self cannot be corrupted? Our whole world is divided into three. Can you tell? It is waking, dream and deep sleep. There is no other fourth experience. If at all we can use the word fourth experience, that is the experience of the realization. But till we are not realized, we have only these three. All your experiences can come under these three terms. The waking experience, the dream experience and the deep sleep experience. Every day you are going through these three without any choice. Without any choice. And the self that you are, what you really are, is independent of these three. And what have we done to ourselves? Just to expand a little bit, not going too much in detail. We have taken the waking world to be the most real, and we discard the dream world as it's a figment of imagination. And in deep sleep, we say, oh, every day, why do you want to go into deep sleep? To rejuvenate yourself. But we only take the waking experience to be the real one. If you want to take them, take all the three. Or you don't take any one of them. See? So here the Lord is just saying this much, that who you are essentially is other than the waker who is experiencing the waking world. You are other than the dreamer who is experiencing the dream world. You are other than the deep sleeper who is experiencing the deep sleep world. You have got nothing to do with this. Then who is experiencing? But I sleep, I wake up, I dream. No, you don't. The mind does. This is a wrong notion that we experience, because we have got so identified with our mind that we don't realize that we are other than the mind. Yet there are moments in our life when suddenly we fall back and we watch it. See? Expression of this Atma is like the light. Light is there and you have got a prism in front of you. When that light passes through the prism, what do you see on the other side? Seven colors, isn't it? Exactly the same way. Exactly the same way. You are the self, the prism is the mind, and when this light passes through it, first it bifurcates into two. What are those two? Aham vritti and idam vritti. I thought and that thought. And the interaction of this I thought and that thought, the interaction of these two creates a thought in your mind. I thought cannot exist by itself, that thought cannot exist by itself. There should be a marriage between the two. The subject I, the object that, the subject and object must meet. Only then a thought is created. But where is this subject and object idea? In the mind. And this subject remains the same, but the objects keep changing. The son comes in front of you, you call yourself mother. Husband comes in front of you, you call yourself wife. Sister comes in front of you, you call yourself. I is the same. But you are defining this I based on the object that is coming in front of you. But even though this whole interaction of I and that is going on, but this whole thing that is the mind, this is the mind, it is functioning because the self, the reality, the divinity is supporting that mind from within and without. But sir, how do we know? How do we come to know this? Belofai papad, then you will come to know. For that, sadhana is required. For that, purification of the mind is required. And we have seen enough now. How do you purify the mind? The easiest way, or straightforward way, the most effective way, the sure shot. What is the way?
Take the name of the Lord.
Like there is no tomorrow. Lag jao. Be after him. Not mechanically. Take the name of the Lord with deep love and devotion and commitment and sincerity. Yenendriyarthan dhyayeta mrusha swapna vadutthitah tanmirudhyadindriyani vinidra pratyapadyata. In the 32nd verse he says, the man or human beings must understand that just as ephemeral, imaginary, unreal the objects of the dream world are, when you are in the dream, what do you see? You see space, air, fire, water, earth. You see rivers, mountains, seasons. You see your body. You see other bodies. You see other beings. You see other egos. There also you experience anger, greed, jealousy, etc., etc. But the moment you wake up, how much value do you give to the dream that you had? Zero. And how much value we give to the waking world? 150%. Give zero value to the waking world also. Everyone has become quiet. If we are sincere in wanting to realize the Lord, then this prerequisite has to come about. It will come by His grace only. It will come by His grace. But the importance that we give to this waking world. Swamiji, don't say like this. I just got married. Abhi to whole life is in front of me. And you are telling waking world is imaginary. But if you are sincere about recognizing the truth, forget about recognizing the truth. If you are sincere about wanting to be happy permanently, without a break, in that experience of happiness, why do you go to deep sleep? Tell me, do you get the happiness of deep sleep ever in your dream? Do you get the happiness of deep sleep, the bliss that you experience in deep sleep? Do you get it in a dream, or can you get it in the waking plane from anything? By drugs, by drink, by partners, by children, by possessions. You cannot get that happiness. Yet, because if it was that you got that happiness which is from the world, then you will not go into deep sleep. You'll continue to be awake all the time. But whatever you may be, billionaire or a pauper, you will go into deep sleep, because that is where you are closest to your essential nature, but you don't know that. See? So here, the Lord is saying that humans must understand that just like we discard the dream experience of all the beings of all the dream world with all its people. Again, second point here. In the dream, have the people, have the space, air, fire, water, earth, have the rivers, mountains, have the experiences, have the sense stimuli, have they come from outside and entered into your mind in the dream? No, that mind alone became everything, isn't it? That one mind became the dreamer, and that one mind itself became the dream world with all its facets. So is true about this waking experience also. This mind itself has become the waker, and this mind itself has become the waking world. It is worthy of discard. Don't hold on to it. If you hold on to it, the Lord will not come. Even though He is present everywhere, He will not reveal Himself to you. Because as long as you are fixated on form, as long as you are fixated on experience, as long as you are fixated on only one third of your whole mind which is waking, the Lord says, no. Slog more in this world till you get frustrated with this world, and then I will come. See? So here he says, so those people who are thinking about the world, they're thinking about, contemplating upon the objects of the world, there's nothing wrong. Gopis did not stop doing their job. Oh, but how is that possible? Swamiji, I have to construct my house. Swamiji, I have to buy a new car. Swamiji, I have to start a family. Swamiji, I have to go through school and then get married. Swamiji, I have to get my son married. And so many things. Swami, I have to retire and then I'm going to enjoy. Gopis also did all that. They did not run away from the world. They did not run away from the world. They did not run away from their responsibilities also. They did not run away from their duties. They did not run away from their family. They did not run away from, I am spiritual now. Husband, you take over the kitchen. Children, you start taking care of the vacuuming and dishwashing and washing clothes and washing machine and gardening. And mummy, what will you do? I am the witness. I am the witness. Not like that. The gopis got up in the morning, they milked the cows, they churned the butter, they took the cows for the grazing, they fought with their husbands, they scolded their children, they loved their children, they cooked the food, they fed, did everything. But while doing everything, they did not forget the Lord. Is that possible in this world? Or is it only an imaginary, years ago when Krishna, 700 years ago when Krishna was there. Who knows, Swamiji? I was not there. Someone must have written this to confuse us. Always must check what is written with your own experience. Is it possible right now?
Absolutely.
Example? I'm asking.
Waking dream.
Huh? No, Vedanta mat maane. Give me a solid example that you are going through in life.
Every day you put gopi before
you. No. I'm talking about gopis doing everything and not forgetting the Lord.
When you get up in the morning and you put gopi, when some difficulty comes, when some joy comes, you always do puja, we remember the Lord a different way.
So what about in between them? All the time problems are coming. No.
In between them is training.
I'll give you an example. Two examples, one from Panchadashi and one from our daily life. Well, suppose your child has not come back from school. Where is the mum's or dad's attention on that child? where is that child must be, where is he, has he got lost, has he got kidnapped, is there, always negative things first, has there been an accident, but because those thoughts are coming, you know you have to cook, you know you have to do something, all that is going on still, but your mind is on the child. Because your mind is on the child, have you forgot to put salt in the vegetable? Have you forgotten to put the washing machine on? No. Have you forgotten to wear clothes? No. You're doing everything, but your attention is on the mind's attention is single pointedly on the child. A more crude example given in Panchadashi of how mind you can do everything and yet think of the Lord. Here it is not the Lord, here it is the beloved. One married woman. The husband has gone to school work. The husband has gone to work. The children have gone to school. After doing all her chores in the house, she goes to do the vegetable shopping and eyes meet eyes with some man there. One day she sees, second day she sees, third day she sees. Slowly, slowly they come. Hey, how are you? What is your name? This, that. And slowly, slowly, only knowing, then touching, then hugging. Now all the time, you don't appreciate those who are near and dear. You always like those who are far away. That person who is far away, you remember more intensely. So she is thinking about her beloved so intensely, but nobody at home can even suspect that she is thinking about that fellow while doing everything at home. The children think it's the same mother, husband is saying. In fact, her performance at home becomes better when she falls in love outside. So did gopis. Gopis fell in love with Krishna. And they performed all their activities at home or in their life 110%. Nothing to complain about. Because efficiency comes with that. Here, imagine if the attention is on some beloved, but here Gopi's beloved is the Lord himself. How much more inspiration will be there? So take only the Lord, not cancel the other one. Everyone will experiment. Don't miss the point. Point is, what was the point? Tell me. Or you have forgotten the point in the story. The point was?
You can do everything.
While doing everything, you can still continue to remember the Lord in and through every activity of your life. For that, these two examples were given. Now you have to put your mind to it. It will not happen by itself. In the 33rd verse, he says, Etadanta samagnayo
yoga sankhyam manishinam tyagastapodamas satyam samudranta ivapagaha.
Just in the manner as all the rivers, they go around everywhere, up and down, and here and there, and curve here and curve there, and never in a straight line. But eventually, they meet the ocean. Similarly, that the yogis or the tapasvis or the people who are practicing as austerity, and what do they do with in those practices? They practice detachment, they practice renunciation, they practice austerities, they practice control of their senses, they practice speaking the truth all the time, they practice yoga, they practice discrimination, and eventually they only reach the same reality. And they have the gopis practiced anything of this? So they have not practiced yoga, they have not practiced discrimination, they have not sat in meditation, they have not chanted any name of the Lord, they have not done any austerities, they have not done any rituals, they have not done any upasana, they have not controlled their senses. They have not controlled their anger, greed, jealousy. The negative expressions also they have not controlled. See? Have they got detached from anything? No, they have not got detached from anything. They didn't renounce. They didn't renounce anything. Then what have they done? All they have done is they put their mind on the Lord while everything is being. This is friction-free journey to the Lord. When you practice Dhamma, heat will be generated. You practice Vairagya, heat will be generated. You practice detachment, pain will be there. Oh, I love my, family, but why the scriptures are saying detach, detach, detach and attach to the Lord. I can't detach. Very difficult. True, isn't it? We appreciate all this, but nobody says it here. Why should I be the fool in the whole group? Right? Let others say it. Why should I say that? Here, gopis are not even talking about detachment. All they know is, while everything that is going on, we have to remember the divine. And they are not even making an attempt to remember the divine. They are so much in love with Krishna. There's so much. See, when a mother is there, even my mother, even today, if some child, some small baby comes, and she says, my son also was 54-year-old and still child. Let that small young mother, she's wanting to show off her baby, and you are bringing your 50-year-old man, son, to compare with that small child. It's silly. Why should I take any other example when their example is right in front?
But the mother only sees her child and every child.
So instead of, just like that, mother sees her child, she doesn't see her child in every child. If she saw her child in every child, then she would not talk about, then she will talk about that child that has come in front of her.
She sees that child of that age.
Living in imagination. Living in the past. So here, nothing, no comparison, nothing. Continuously remembering the divine theme. And in this manner, automatically, the mind is just like all the rivers conclude their journey in the ocean. All practices, whether from all the religions, if you may use that word, they conclude in the divine alone. Recognition of this while living, not just intellectually, but direct experience of this, and living it is realization, is God realization. And this state the gopis are in, this state the great Mahatmas are in. See, continuing,
yatvaham bhavati nam vai dure varte priyo dusham मनसन्निकर्षार्थं मदनुध्यानकाम्यया यथा दूरचरे प्रेष्ठे मन आविश्य सन्निकृष्टे क्षिगोचरे मह्यावेश्य मनकृत्स्नं विमुक्ताशेषवृत्तियत अनुस्मान्तो अचिरान् मामुपैष्यथ या मया क्रीडता रात्र्यां वने अस्मिन् व्रज आस्थिताः अलब्ध सा कल्पाण्यो कल्याण्यो कल्याण्यो मा मापुर्मद्वीर्यचिन्तया
so we are on where? We are on verse number 34. So here he says, Yatvaham bhavati nam vai dure varte priyo drusham manasa sannikarshaya karshartham madanodhyana kamyaya. The Lord says here that through Uddhava Maharaj is telling the story. The Lord tells one very beautiful thing, and what he says, O gopis, O darlings, I do not have any doubt. This is the assurance. When a child hears from his parents or his teacher a sign that, well done son or well done daughter, that fantastic, he feels. At least someone is appreciating. Some people get addicted to that. They want continuous appreciation, praise. If not, their performance goes down. Right? You all experience that? Gopis are not like that. Whether you appreciate or you don't appreciate, they are ever inspired. Because whom are they thinking of all the time? The Lord. Lord is inspiration incarnate. See? So here they say, in the Lord is telling them something. It's like a certificate to the gopis. He says that there is no doubt that I am the greatest thing for anyone to gain in life. I am the greatest thing for anyone to gain in life, the Lord is saying. It's like the water is saying, I am the greatest thing for anyone to gain. For whom? For all the waves, the greatest thing to gain is the infinite waters, isn't it? So it's not, the Lord is not on an ego trip, okay? Don't go in that direction. The Lord is saying, I am the greatest thing that there is to gain. And I am the most important thing in this creation. And even though I am far away from you, I'll tell you why I am so far away from you. Because when someone is far away, the urge to be with that one who is far away, it increases many folds. It increases many folds. The example, when the gopis were being called by the Krishna by playing his flute for Ras Leela on the full moon night, and all of them were running towards them, and they reached Krishna, and then they felt that how lucky they are that they have come to meet Krishna, and they are with Krishna, and it must have been good deeds because of which they have done good merits in their life, because of which this opportunity has presented itself to them. The moment their attention went on their good merits, Krishna vanished. Isn't it? And then we had the Gopika Geeta. And what was Gopika Geeta all about? It was about pining for the Lord. Did they pine for the Lord when the Lord was in front of them? Then when do you pine for the Lord? When did they pine? When he went away from them. And their intensity, all their energies got collected, and they expressed such deep emotions of love that the Lord had to come back. Isn't it? Another example, if you remember. When Krishna played the flute, many gopis in thousands came to meet Krishna, but some were not allowed by their brothers and their husbands and their, to leave the house. They locked them up or they chained them. It didn't say chain, okay? They didn't allow them. And what happened to those gopis? That that their inability to go to the call of Krishna, they thought about Krishna so intensely that there and then, while remaining in the house, they became one with Krishna and they left their bodies. See? Some left, some stayed, but what did the rest of the thousands of gopis, they still have to go through the process of Ras Leela. The journey is elongated for them. Whereas for those gopis who were not allowed, there and then, everything was over. See? Reality is present everywhere. Choose, you want to elongate that process or you want to catch that reality right here and now. It is only in the now that you can catch it, can be it, not even catch it, you can be it. So the Lord is saying here, the reason I stay away from you is so that your intensity of love towards me may it increase. And O gopis, then in the 34th verse, he says, the more I stay away from you, the more you feel the oneness with me. See? Then he says in the 35th verse, I can't read it here.
Yatha durachare preshte mana avishya vartate strinam chana tha chetaha sannikrushte kshigochare.
He says that the reason that I am far away from you is so that you continuously, without a break, contemplate upon me, and your mind, you place it in me, because here the Lord is saying that Stridam chana yatha cheta sanni krushte kshi gochare. So keep your mind in me and all your senses are automatically controlled without wanting to control them. And here the point that I made before, that we remember our beloved more intensely than those who are immediately present in front of us. And in this way, he says in the 36th verse that Maya Veshamana Kritsnam Vimukta Shesha Vrittiyata Anusmarantyo Mam Nityam Achiran Mam Upaishyata. This verse is resonating a similar verse in Bhagavad Gita. Maya Veshamana Kritsnam. So, Maya Veshya. So, place your mind in me. How do you place your mind in me? Have you ever done this? You think of someone, if you have to experiment it, I have experimented it. I have told you this incident from long ago. I used to think of a girl. Swamiji, which direction are you going? I was thinking of a gopi. And I used to think of her intensely. And in that intensely, my thing was, she's calling me, she's inviting me for dinner, she's paying the bill, because I was in my sadhana stage and I wanted to experiment. And I thought so intensely that very next, within 2 minutes, that girl called me. She said, come, let's go out for dinner. I said, okay. We went, she paid the bill, she picked me up, she dropped me back home. I said, okay, so this works. So a few more times I tried. Just like when you think of a fear intensely, it becomes true. You manifest that fear in your life. If you think intensely of any person, you will manifest that person in your life. So who was someone? Someone I told, I sent a, yesterday I sent a from the MCG, I sent a SMS with photograph on WhatsApp to New Zealand. I said, "Ah, we are here enjoying the match and this and that." And the next SMS came that, "Swamiji, I was thinking about you just half an hour ago. And here you are immediately, you are sending me a message." Ho gaya? When we are, another example I'll tell you. This is very uncanny. But these things happen to everyone. I'm just telling you what has happened. We were in Bali just now, last week. And we climbed the volcano, Mount Batur. Shri was there with us. And while going, when we left home, it was cloudy. And when we reached 3:30, we started the walk, still cloud. Who was there? I don't know. Who was there with me? You and me only. And I screamed out 2-3 times, "Hanumanji, start doing your job, otherwise I'll complain to your dad." Who is his dad? Shiva. Or 2-3 times, and I really felt that I was talking to him. I said, "Meri feeling thi." Who knows? You just make a prayer. If it happens, you feel that, oh, something has clicked. And sometimes it doesn't happen. Yaar, suna nahi, pata nahi kya hai. But 10 minutes, 15 minutes later, there was not one single cloud. And we had a wonderful intensity I'm talking about here. The intensity that you have when you work. The intensity, the relaxed intensity that you have to maintain your family, to nourish your children, to take care of your partners, and to take care of all this. It's an intense awareness is required to take care of every aspect of your family, isn't it? It is not easy. Now imagine, you withdraw all the intensity from there, and you apply it to the remembrance of the Lord. Maya Veshya. Mano Buddhi. The Lord's there in Bhagavad Gita it comes. Place your mind and intellect in me. Here he's saying, place Maya, where is that? Maya Veshya Manakritnam. Vimukta Ashesha Vritti Yata. He says, place Maya Veshya, enter. Make your mind enter into me. How do you make your mind enter into me? Into me means into the Lord. Remember once we did meditation that was given here in Bhagavatam itself. It was told, look at the Lord. This is how everyone begins. Look at the whole form of. First you remember the stories of the Lord. Then after your mind is saturated with the stories, now your mind is so in love with the Lord that you don't want all other characters. You want only the Lord. And then you start looking at the Lord. Then the Lord, kya karenge? Again, same clothes, same garland, same hand, same everything. No. You want to, wherever your attention is, if your love is for his feet, your attention will go to his feet. If your attention is on his eyes, your attention will go to his eyes. If your attention is on his lips, it will go to his lips. So just these three examples. If it goes to the feet, so you forget slowly, because of your attention on the feet, rest of the body vanishes, only the feet remain in your mind. Rest of the body vanishes, only the two eyes remain in your mind. Only the two lips remain in your mind. So what has happened? From manyness, your mind has become focused on the two eyes or the two lips or the... First it was focused on the stories. It had forgotten the world. Then it became focused on the form of the Lord. Then it became focused on one, two eyes or two lips or two feet. And as it keeps looking at the two eyes or the two lips or the two feet, it remains there. It will happen. What happens? Then the mind enters between the two lips. The mind enters between the two eyes. The mind enters into the two feet, the gap between the two feet. To become one with the, then even the form of the feet doesn't remain, the form of the lips doesn't remain, the form of the eyes doesn't remain. Then you and the Lord are one. Samadhi. this, remember, long time ago it came, I don't know in which canto or chapter. Dhruv Maharaj story. बोलो हनुमान महाराज की जय। भागवत भागवत की तो है ही, पर अभी हनुमान महाराज की, बिकॉज आंसर वॉज रिक्वायर्ड, आई डोंट नो द आंसर। ध्रुव महाराज स्टोरी, बट रिमेंबर दैट। सो दीज आर वेरी पर्टिनेंट एक्सरसाइजेस दैट यू मस्ट और वी मस्ट प्रैक्टिस इन अवर डेली लाइफ। If you can't practice to that intensity, intensely remember the stories of the Lord, automatically this stage will come. So here it says, he says, place your mind, maya vesha mana kristam. Place your mind in me or on me, because if you keep it on the opposite sex and if you keep it on your lovers and contemplate on them, then, and whenever if a man is thinking about the woman or about the lover, then the mind becomes concentrated on them, and automatically after some time you are thinking about your beloved, then you forget the sleep, you forget the food, you forget the matches, you forget the exams, you forget everything. Why? Because you're thinking of your beloved, isn't it? Of your partner, fiance. You should have seen. Secret bata raha hu. And I'm not the, all of these are the proof. They will second it. You don't know what his state was. That's why we came to see how he will be when he gets married. तुम्हारी बात कर रहा हूँ मनोज, और किसी की नहीं, उसकी नहीं। मैं निधि से बात कर रहा हूँ। मनोज एकदम सीरियस हो गया। ये साक्षी है, श्री साक्षी, मिनी साक्षी, दिनेश साक्षी, सीमा साक्षी, द किड्स आर साक्षी। इसकी इतनी खींची हमने पहले भागवत में शादी के पहले। So whenever the beloved is in front of our eyes, whenever the lover is in front of our eyes, whenever the opposite sex is in front of our eyes, then our mind is not available to contemplate on the Lord. Lord could have said the objects also, but objects don't attract us as much as a living person, you know. So then in the 37th verse, ya maya, ya maya kridata ratryam vanesmen raja akshitaha alabdhara kana ma virya chintaya. In the 37th verse he says that before he said anusmarantyo mam nityam, anusmaranto mam nityam. So first, in the first part of the verse, he said if you think about your beloved and opposite sex, you will never be able to think about me. Then in the second part of the verse, anusmarantyo, again and again, this is a practice that is told, again and again, think about me, remember me, contemplate on me, and then nityam, continuously. Try to do it as frequently as possible, as many times during the day as possible. Don't do it only one time and then, yaar, oh, baap re, it was a big effort to keep the Lord in the mind, and rest of the day then you can't remember. Why? You're afraid, I will get tired like I did in the morning. No, do it for a few seconds, Then after 5 minutes, again for few seconds. Then again few seconds. Then again few seconds. Make it many, 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 many times during the day, but with intensity. And automatically, before you know, it starts happening. It remains in your mind without your efforts. The Lord's name, the image of the Lord or the name of the Lord. And then he says, Ya maya kriditam ratriyam vanesmin vraja asthitaha. Then again to clarify what he has just now said to the gopis, the Lord says that that when we were doing Ras Leela, all the gopis had given attention to their saubhagya, they had given attention to their good merits, because of which they had found the Lord, or that the Lord had called them. So their attention had gone away from me. Do you remember? So he's clarifying. And that time I vanished, and then you intensely remembered me, didn't you? So it is your experience. That's why I'm staying away from you in Mathura, so that you remember me intensely. So Bhagwan knows how to get out of Patli Gali. And in this way, just like at that time, with single pointed mind, with focused mind, with concentrated mind, you thought about me, and I had no other choice but to appear back in your midst during the Ras Leela. Similarly, and just like those gopis who could not come to the Ras Leela, they realized me while they were in their home only. Similarly, while I am staying away, I know that you are thinking of me intensely. You are interacting with the thought of mine very intensely. I am not far away from you. I am in you as you. He's already told me, I am the creator and I am the material. So he has already said, everything in this creation is pervaded by me. The only missing ingredient is, what is the missing ingredient? The intensity of concentration, the intensity of single-pointed focus. That is what is the missing ingredient. See, and that comes through separation. Your child was in Europe. We only used to hear about my son is dead, now he's king, now he's here, now he's there. So in this way, see, when we contemplate on the Lord, so suppose this is the I thought, and this is the that thought. This is the expression in the mind. The mind is a play between subject and object. ठीक है? This subject, I am thinking, I am contemplating, I am taking the name of what? Of the Lord. The Lord has become the object, right? But who is the Lord essentially? Not other than the subject. So when this I keeps contemplating on the Lord again and again and again and again, I gave you one example just now, the two eyes, the two feet, two lips. When he keeps thinking, wanting to merge, wanting to become one, wanting to realize the Lord and lose his identity as a contemplator, as a devotee, he's not even thinking, he's just loving the Lord, therefore he's thinking. Eventually, because the theme that he's contemplating upon, divinity, is not other than what he essentially is, the merging takes place. And this is what we saw in the Ras Leela, the three stages. And in this way, recognize this is the way to give up the jiva bhav and come to realize what you really are. That is the purpose of life. Our purpose of life is not to give only reality to the waking world and to the waking people, to the waking possessions, waking world possessions, and continue to complain about the wars, the terrorists, the etc., and think about the share market going up or going down, or talk about why the petrol price is up and why the petrol price is down, then talk about, I think there is a syndicate among all the petrol stations to not reduce the thing. Who cares, man? If your attention is on all this, Lord is far away. Whenever in life you take up anything for discussion, it should be a general principle. It should not be specific to you. General principle is talk about gravity. General principle is talk about space. General principle, the sun is shining. Kya kar sakte ho? Nothing. Nothing is gained, nothing is lost. General principle, again, as you start doing this practice, slowly, slowly you are understanding, why am I only thinking about space in and sun in waking state? I see sun in the dream also. So that one is real or this one is real? This is called, start thinking like this, then what will happen? You'll go crazy, that's all. Nothing else will happen. You'll go crazy. One less problem in the world. Generalize. Always take the three states. Your complete day includes not 12 hours or 10 hours of waking state. It includes the dream state and it should include the deep sleep state also. If we are not giving reality to dream and deep sleep, then we should give the same reality to the waking also. If you are giving reality to the waking, then give reality to the dream as much as you give reality to waking. Give as much reality to the deep sleep also. Then think intensely, I must go into my dream and fix up my marriage there. Huh? That's waking dream. But we don't do that. We don't go and try to fix. Sometimes some fools do. They get up in the morning, get up, achhi dream thi, go back again. try to enjoy the dream a little bit more. And they keep searching, where has that dream gone? It never comes back. Don't live in an imaginary world. Waking, dream and deep sleep, all three are imaginary worlds. Then what is reality? Reality is only one. That is consciousness. That is the Lord. You, as an individual, you can never recognize the Lord. As an individual. As the Lord, when you have become one with the Lord, you don't need to recognize the Lord because you are one with Him. And you will see the whole world also as the Lord only. That's how the gopis are living. We are caught up in our self-made trap of thoughts and wrong convictions and wrong notions in our own mind and intellect. We have created it. A spider creates a cobweb, but he never gets caught up in his cobweb. He only catches other to devour, isn't it? We have created a cobweb in our mind of joy, sorrow, likes, dislikes, hunger, thirst, anger, greed, jealousy. All these are thoughts. It keeps creating, and it has become such a big what do you call? Bhul bhulaiya ko kya bolte hai? Huh? Bubble. No, not bubble. Bhul bhulaiya. A maze. It has. We have created such a maze, and we have entered into that maze of thoughts, and now we are not finding a way out. The only one who can take you out of this maze of thoughts, this cobweb of thoughts is the divine. That's the only solution. The other way is which you experience every day. Sleep also takes you away from the cobweb of thoughts. But in sleep, you are not aware that you are out. Because you are dead to the world. You are dead to the mind also. So in this way, so the Lord says, I am so far away from you, O my darlings, so that I can remain very close to you. Because physically I may be far away, but I am in your heart and mind because I am far away. You are only thinking about me all the time and I know it. Shri Shuka Uvacha, evam priyatamadishtam akarnya vrajayoshitah tapuchuruddhavam pritah tatsandeshagata smritihi. Delighted to hear the message of Sri Krishna, their most beloved Lord, the ladies, the women of Vraja, spoke to Uddhava in the following. Now the gopis will start saying their memories of Sri Krishna having been awakened by his message. And what do they, till now what they had been doing? Complaining. Till now they had been complaining. And now you see what they say. See, if you take our Jnaneshwari, Jnaneshwar Maharaj, you have heard, we are taking some text of Gita by him and Amrita Anubhav. You take Tukaram, you take Eknath Maharaj, you take Anandamayi Ma, you take Amrita Anandamayi Ma. When the bhajans are going, what happens to her? The sudden shiver and her voice goes somewhere. That's the viraha. That's the separation. The viraha geet. Our Gopika geet was a viraha geet. It was born out of experiencing, wanting to be one, but cannot be one because the beloved is not there. The Lord is not there. That's when poetry comes out. There was one movie which we saw, Punjabi.
Varis Shah.
In that, he's a poet, he's a Sufi guy, and he wants to learn poetry, and he asked, who can I study, whom I can study from, with poetry from, who can teach me, I want a teacher, I want a guru. He doesn't know who is his guru, but the guru knows who, that this fellow is going to come one day. And he's asking, he has to find his journey. Nothing is given on the plate. You have to do the hard slog. So he finds out and someone tells him, hey, there is this master, you go to him. And when he going on the way, the master appears in front of him. And he says, where are you going? I'm going to, he's a fool man, where you're going? He doesn't know anything. What you're going to learn? You're going to learn poetry from him. He's never written a meaningful poetry in his whole life. You're going to that fool. He said, no. I have decided and I'm going to go and learn from him. And eventually, 2-3 times he tries to distract him. Eventually he gets there. And when he gets there, he sees the same man standing up there in front. He says, I was waiting for you. He says, please take me as your shagird, as your disciple.
Understudy
or disciple. He says, yes, you will write, but poetry does not come like that by becoming a disciple. Poetry does not come by going to a ashram and studying scriptures. Love for the Lord does not come by study, through study of scriptures. Then what? How does it come? He says, have you ever fallen in love? He says, no. Has anyone broken your heart? He says, no. Then you can never write poetry. He says only this much. And next moment, Aurangzeb's soldiers come and he starts singing. They say, Aurangzeb has sent to bring you because we have to behead you because you have the rule says that you cannot sing and you are singing. He says, who cares? I know I'm already dead. And he sings all the way to his execution. And this fellow says, how can the person, he's watching his teacher. He's going away for execution and he's singing away, no fear in his heart. Why? His mind has become one with the Lord, Allah. Allahu, Allahu, aata hai. Oh, beautiful. You listen to it, your hair will stand up. And then this fellow goes, where his teacher at, you go there. He starts writing an imaginary story, a love story, an imaginary love story. And the moment he gets into the village, he goes to the head zamindar. He says, okay, this house is empty, you stay there. And he tells his daughter that you go and give him some food, this traveler has come. Oh, okay, and what do you want to do? I want to write poetry. Very good, you write poetry. He starts, and when he was coming, this girl took him for a ride. He says, nay, the village is that side, it's not this side. Something like that. And eventually he finds that this is the girl who's coming and bringing the food. And that prompts the poetry in him. And he starts writing. But it is still, maja nahi aa raha hai. You know, he's not enjoying. Like our Narad Muni, he had studied 64 knowledges. That complete knowledge of the entire universe was at his fingertips. But still he was empty from inside. And in that end he was, imagine you have all the knowledge of the world and still you are depressed. Knowledge does that. And when he was walking, his brothers come. Hey, younger brother, what's happened to you? I don't know. He says, have you fallen in love? No. Whom should I fall? What is worthy of falling in love with? Narayana, go, take his name. He becomes the greatest devotee. And that Narad Muni, who is the greatest devotee of the Lord, he says, even greater than me are these gopis. See? Similarly, Maharishi Vedvyas, when he was, he had collated all the Vedas, he had, through his memory from previous lives, he had written all the Puranas, he has written the Mahabharat, huge volume of work he has done. But, and he has studied, he knows everything, he knows the truth, everything, but his heart is empty. Heart is empty. And he's sitting there. Kya hoga? I don't know. Why am I feeling this emptiness? You know, such a master, when he feels emptiness, answer has to come straight because he is aware. And he feels, why is this? I have done everything that was there to do. Why am I still experiencing this emptiness in my heart? At that very moment, Narad Muni comes. He says, oh, Narad Muni, what are you thinking? This is my thought. He says, have you experienced the love and devotion? You know everything, but have you experienced it? Are you immersed in it? Maharishi Vedvyas is himself the Lord's incarnation, but he needs that treatment also. Hanumanji himself is a amsha, is a part of Lord Shiva, but he needs initiation, he needs knowledge from the Lord Sun, he needs initiation from Lord Shiva in the mantra called Ram. And when he gets the name Ram from Lord Shiva, his whole waking dream, he doesn't sleep only, all the time Ram, 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 Ram. Nothing he can do. He is incapable of doing anything. Parents are worried. Oh, beta gaya haath se. That's all they can think of. And then, because his mind is so intensely tuned with the divine name, the nature conspires to bring the union with his go, with his Lord. It everything happens. Lord Shiva himself comes, carries him, and you take him to Lord Ram. See, this is possible in every one of our lives. It is happening in other ways, but we don't have the vision to recognize that it is taking place all the time. We don't have that vision. We are still fixated on wanting this from world and wanting... The technology is exactly the same, but it has to be applied not on something that which comes and goes, not on something which is ephemeral, not on something which is finite, but it has to be applied on the infinite, something immortal, something indestructible, something all-pervasive, something eternal. When we do that, while living on this earth, in this body, you'll be one with Lord, like the gopis are. And there are n number of examples in this, even today, all over the planet, of such masters who are living in communion with the divine. Till where we are done? Gopya Uchuhu, what's the time?
Quarter past eight.
8:15. We'll do 3-4 verses and then we will conclude. Gopya uchuhu deshtya hito hata kanso yadunam kanu godhakrut vishtya mair labdha. I can't read. Deshtya tair labdha sarvarthaihi कुशल्यास्तेच्युतोधुना कश्चिद्गदाग्रजः सौम्यः करोति पुरयोषिताम् प्रीतिनास्निग्धसद्विडहासोदारे क्षणार्चितः कथं रतिविशेषज्ञः प्रियश्च वरयोषिताम् नानुबध्येत तद्वाक्यैः विभ्रमैश्चानुभाजितः अपि स्मरति न साधो गोविंद प्रस्तुते क्वचित गोष्ठी मध्ये पुरस्त्रीणा ग्राम्या स्वैर कथा तरे गोष्ठी मध्ये पुरस्त्रीणा ग्राम्या स्वैर कथांतरे. सो गोप्यौचु हैविंग हर्ड द मैसेज फ्रॉम उद्धवाज माउथ, the message of their beloved Lord Shri Krishna, and his conclusion was, I am separate from you because so that your mind keeps thinking of me intensely, and when it keeps thinking of me intensely, you and me will become one. Then you will find me in your own heart and mind without me being present there. See, if you take, just before we go ahead, you must have read so many stories, Ramanujacharya, our Tukaram. I'm just taking one or two. Anandmayi Ma, Bhagwati Amma in Badrinath, whom you have met, or few of you, no, she has met, and Raghu had met. They have thought of the Lord so intensely that the Lord manifests in front of them. Another example from the Puranas, you look at our Dhruva Maharaj. He thinks, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, the Lord comes in front of him. See? Those who have been devotees of Satya Sai Baba, they have thought about him so intensely, he appears in their life. And I'm not saying this just because like that. No, it has, these are example, true examples. Samartha Ramdas. You take our Shirdi Sai Baba in that pothi. He is in Dwarka Mai and other people are experiencing him somewhere else. He comes because they call out to him, the divinity, the Lord appears.
Swami Samartha
also. He said Swami Samartha. He also did that. So it happens. Many people, when their mind is purified and they are thinking of the Lord, the Virat Purush appears to them. Virat Purush, Sahasra Shirsha Purusha Sahasraksha Sahasrapat. So that form, it appears to them in their mind. Some people, you go to Kailash, some people have come with me, they see Lord Shiva. I have not seen Lord Shiva till now. He is in the heart. But some people, for them, they have seen it. They say, no, I have felt the presence. Some people, when they go to the Mansarovar, they see the lights coming down, they see the swans, they see the gods coming. Because they think about it so intensely. They want that experience. But that experience will also go away. What do we want? We want an eternal experience in which there is no break. And that eternal experience is merging into the divine. Not a specific experience. Specificity always begins and ends. Eternity has no beginning and no end. Once you merge into it, there is no more coming back. Yad gatvana nivartante. So always, when we are as spiritual seekers, our attention should be on such themes which do not lead into any conclusion. So here, in Vedanta, we say it that way. Eternal, unborn, undying, all-pervading, all-permeating, all-knowing. The same can be achieved by remembering the Lord. Same can be achieved. If you go to, you know, you this transcendental meditation, you have heard of Maharishi Mahesh Yogi? They don't initiate you with any name of the Lord. So, come, I'll give you initiation. Table. Start. Table. Table, 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 table. You come. Shoo. I'm just joking. I don't know what they say. I've never been initiated. But they will give some garbar. Okay, garbar. You keep, all that is required is a focus. That's all. To a point where you come to realize the mantra is being chanted by the mind and you are not the mind. In devotion, we take the theme of the Lord. Here we are not. When you take the theme of the Lord, eventually you will recognize that the mind is doing the chanting and you are other than it. Then who is this? This is the Lord. You merge into it. It is a knowingless knowing. It is an experienceless experience. So here in the 39th verse. In the 39th verse, now the gopis start blabbering. Because they are so happy that the Lord has sent a special message for them. When you nowadays email, you know. It's happening. Someone's house I went, they said, my birthday and I did not get any message from anyone on the Facebook that happy birthday. I think nobody loves me. Not my God, this is a real man. If they had written my God, many answers would have come. Nobody loves me. So they determine their happiness based on the likes that they get. So imagine I sent a photograph, I'm calling, I am in MCG, and nobody answered. I think nobody appreciates that I am in MCG. and I determine, I allow that to determine my happiness at MCG. Pathetic, isn't it? But that is how the young kids are today. Why are the young kids, grown-ups also? Every tak 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 tak. So here, we must not allow our happiness to be determined by acceptance or rejection by others. As long as your heart is clear, as long as your heart is sincere in its love for the divine, everything will fall in place. That intrinsic faith within your heart. See, Swamiji says that whenever you take the name of the Lord, it's not how many times you take the name, but you take one name with great intensity. And this I was remembering on Thursday. I was doing the overview of Bhagavad Gita chapter 8 in the class, and there it was told how to die. Death is a principle. Death is not an event in life. Agree or not? What is death? Unmanifestation of the present manifestation, right? Unmanifestation of the present manifestation is death. Now tell me, the one who is manifesting right now, and who is this right now? This body, this mind, this particular, today I got maybe two more white hair than yesterday. So was this person available yesterday? Was this body available yesterday? Was this mind available yesterday? Was it? No, it's already one day old. You can never have a repetition in this creation. So that means technically, I have become one day old means the yesterday's me has died and today's me has started. And if you take it, fine-tune it, every moment I'm dying, every moment I'm being born, as the body, as the thoughts, as the emotions, as the personality. See? So death is a principle. It is happening every moment. It's taking place. If you take it that way, then there's no fear. But if you take it as an event, then all the fear. And what is immortality? Transcending this fear of death. Death is only a concept in our mind. It's only an idea. There is nothing called death in this creation. Then what is there in this creation? Only divinity. Only the Lord. When you become deeply, intensely, now in the 8th chapter, Lord says, how to do that? Arjuna is confused. He is saying, what happens to people after death? How can they think of you? Do they go into a Gaga land or they can attain you? He says, if with their last breath they can control their senses, they can intensely gather all the energy from every cell of their body, from every sense organ, from every sense organ of action and perception, and bring that energy. Where is that energy? In the mind only, isn't it? So you withdraw everything, just like you do it in sleep. You withdraw everything from the body, from the world, from the body, from the mind, and apply it at the feet of the sleep. And the sleep sucks you in. Similarly, you gather everything, and with that last breath, you offer it to the Lord. Now, don't wait for that event in life when death comes, because nobody knows when it is coming. And yet, it is happening every moment. So, live intensely in remembrance of the Lord every moment. In this manner, we'll just take one verse and then we'll stop. Shri Gopya Uchuhu, in the 39th verse, He says, one gopi started saying, "Oh, Udhavji." So before they were complaining to Udhavji, how bad Krishna is, how he is that, and now suddenly their tone has changed. So when their tone was that of anger and complaint, the theme was Krishna. Now their attitude has changed towards Uddhav because he has given the message, and everyone is, "Oh, we have treated him, we have downloaded all our problems on him, poor fellow." And let's give him, and then the message that Uddhav has given to them, that prompts them to think about their beloved in loving manner. And now they start, in a very nice disposition of their heart and mind, they start narrating the stories of, or the incidents of, their interaction with Krishna to Uddhava. They say, one gopi says, "Oh, Udhavji, we are very fortunate and we are very happy that comes that baddie that along with his fellow beings was killed by our Lord and the Balramji, and their father and mother and their all the relatives, they are now free, and now we believe that our Krishna, our Shyam Sundar, our Kanha, he must be living very nicely, happily in his house with his father, mother and relatives. Is it not?" Okay, but there is a but after that. "But please tell us that are the girls of Mathura pleasing him just like we used to take care of him?" Are the girls of Mathura attracting his attention? Is he getting attracted to them? But what can we do? Krishna, see, on one side there is complaint, but the very next thing, but what can we say? Krishna is like that. Anyone who looks at him gets attracted. So, do they pray to him? Do they think about him? Do they offer themselves to him with love? Then another says, no. She's not saying that, no. Because there is competition now. They want to know. Everyone is eager to tell Uddhav. Ask Uddhav. The second one says, "Is our Shyam Sundar, he is expert in, what you call, Vashikaran ko kya bolte hai? He is expert in hypnotizing girls. We don't know what he does, but whenever we look, anyone who looks at him gets attracted and they can't stop thinking about him. He's an expert hypnotizer. He's a divine hypnotizer. That is his special ability. And if anyone wants to learn how to hypnotize, you should learn it from Krishna only. Uddhav, you can also do that." The girls in the cities, because all these gopis are in the village, they are saying that these girls in the city of Mathura, they are more sophisticated. They are all a lot of lipstick and mascara and eyeliners and kajal and all the ornaments and nice clothes, and they will be going around and they are very, very clever. And they will speak sweet things to him, and with this type of disposition, if they look at Krishna and talk to Krishna, what can we say? They will get caught up in his trap. See, and in this way, we'll look at it again next week, and they continue to remember. On one hand they are complaining, but now it is out of joy, not out of complaining attitude. They are complaining, but at the same time they are seeing that their Krishna is so great that whatever emotion you apply to it, he cannot be corrupted because his nature is like that. That once you see him, once you know him, once you hear him, once you touch him, once you are embraced by him, you cannot but be in love with him forever. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.